So having had the repêchages, he won in the women's double sculls, and in lane one, representing New Zealand, are Fiona Patterson from Waikato and Anna Reimer from Victoria University in Wellington. Representing Great Britain, who have never lost, by the way, this pairing, Anna Watkins and Catherine Granger, ever popular and seeking a first gold after three silver medals at the Olympic Games. For the Czech Republic, Lanka Antosova and Jitka Antosova, sisters. For China in lane four, we have Wang Min and Xu Weiwei. And finally, in the orange of the Netherlands, Inge Janssen and Elizabeth Ugovic. Well, if there's a more popular competitor here than Catherine Granger, I think I've yet to meet her. She's 36 years of age, and after three silver medals and six world titles, they really do reckon it's her turn to win a gold. But you have to go out there and perform, no matter. But, Granger and Watkins as a combination have never been beaten. Anna Watkins also has an Olympic bronze. This is a compelling race. And off they go. And we'll be extremely excited at this one, I'm sure. It's been quite a wait for them, 3 days before they finally get out onto the water. They've been practicing, of course, every day, hours at a time, and as expected, Great Britain have got off to a good start in lane two and already have a slight advantage over the Netherlands in five. But Great Britain certainly sprinted away from New Zealand in lane one, right from the off. Years of age now, Catherine Granger. There's the New Zealand pairing, Fiona Patterson, she's 29 from Waikato, and Anna Reimer, only 26, who is a member of the Cambridge Rowing Club in New Zealand. But Granger and Watkins already have half a length lead. New Zealand going nicely too in lane one. Sometimes it's good to be in the lane next to the leaders because they bring you along, they drag you along with them. First two across the line will go directly into the finals. Repêchages tomorrow. There's Great Britain in lane two from New Zealand in one. Czech Republic in three, just ahead of China in four. The back markers for the moment are the Netherlands up to, with a quarter of the race gone. 1:35.8 was the Great Britain time. Of course, the fans in the stands, it's a long way to look, is 1,500 metres down a lake. But they are being informed of the development of the race, so they'll know that Watkins and Granger have gone through in first. 36 is the stroke rate at the moment, and they look forward to cheering them home in a couple of minutes' time. That's if they're still in front, as they are at the moment. Things going swimmingly, as you might say, on the lake here at Eton. For Granger and Watkins. There we see the Chinese, Wang Min and Zhu Weiwei. Formidable opponents, without doubt. But, Granger really does deserve a gold medal after her astonishing career. A famous name in British rowing for so many, many years. This fourth Olympic Games attempt to win one. New Zealand then with Patterson and Reimer going nicely in two, also look to be comfortable. And maybe these two crews can sort of ease themselves towards the finishing line without expending too much energy. If they know that they are going to be the first two through, that is good enough, then they can conserve some of that energy. for the next race. China have got up into third place now ahead of the Czech Republic, whose sisters Lenka Antosova and Jitka Antosova did well from the first 500 metres part of the race, but then have just fallen away a little bit. It's Watkins and Granger. So far, so good for the British Challenge. As you would expect here, on home water, it doesn't always work out that way. The Chinese appear to be closing a little bit on New Zealand. 17.6 Watkins on Granger. Still leading the way, and if anything, increasing the margin between themselves and the New Zealand boat in lane one. Now the crowd begin to see what is happening in this race as it unfolds. They move towards the grandstands here with the crowds cheering on the banks of Lake Dorney. Look like achieving the first part of their goal here. A mightily impressive pairing, Catherine Granger and Anna Watkins, who said she took up the sport because she was chubby. Suffered from glandular fever not so long ago. We're at the three-quarter point of the race, 1500 metres gone. Almost bang on the five-minute mark, 5:01.2. It's Watkins and Granger who lead from New Zealand, the Chinese closing just a little bit. Down here the Netherlands edging the Czech Republic into last spot. Remember though, only the first two go through. And it would appear to be Great Britain and New Zealand, a popular story this. Watkins and Granger for Great Britain have not got much further to go, they've not got too much more to do. They come to the first part of the grandstand on the edge of the course now. They go past, but you can see there are no words being exchanged. There is only a pure focus on the job in hand. And the 30 seconds should do it. Watkins and Granger. Names that have become synonymous with British rowing in recent times. It would appear nothing can stop them. And if this is the situation when it comes to the final, you will hear a big roar. Favourites for gold, and this is a gold medal performance from Watkins and Granger. The New Zealand is still going well in lane one though. Let's recognise that Patterson and Raymer have done their job equally well for New Zealand. They managed to stay in touch with the formidable British. And here we have the finishing line, and that is a very good day's work indeed for Catherine Granger and Anna Watkins, who come home ahead of the New Zealand boat in second. They go through to the finals. It's China in third, and the time is 6:44. And it's an Olympic best time. It's just been announced, and look at the smile. 6:44.33 seconds, and that is a real warning to the rest of the field that they've come for gold and they aim to get gold. So another terrific British performance here. In fact, the best performances of the week have come from British and New Zealand crews. Highly satisfactory outcome, but they'll only be too sure to point out that they're only halfway there. But that could not have been more impressive. Very much on course, Catherine Granger and Anna Watkins. There you have it, Olympic best time, 6:44.33, edging out Fiona Patterson and Anna Raymer, who also go through.